Present good morning to one and all respected madams and my dearest friends. I'm Spandana. Now I'm pursuing BA final year. I'm from TTRRDC, Suryapet, Akupamula. My principal madam is Srilata and vice principal madam is Aruna. Friends, before presenting a presentation, I would like to give an example. All economic activities for what purpose? Every human being is engaged in some work. What is the reason to do work? Mainly and majorly to satisfy human wants or to satisfy their want. What are the necessary and necessity want of human beings? What are the necessary and necessity of the want of human beings? Obviously, necessary and necessity want is food. Food, because we can't survive without the food. So, how the food comes to our mouth? The food comes from which sector? Which sector? Obviously, the food comes from agriculture sector. So, friends, today my topic is, my presentation is importance of agriculture. Importance of agriculture. Friends, let's start our program. So, contents. I'm going to concentrate on sectors. So, we have to know what is meaning of sectors. So, every country economy designed on three sectors. How many sectors? Three sectors. That is primary sector, secondary sector and tertiary sector. Okay, primary sector. When we are looking for our Indian economy, our primary sector is agriculture, secondary sector is industries and tertiary sector is service sector. When we are comparing other countries like USA taken as an example, their primary sector in industries, secondary sector services and tertiary sector is agriculture. When we have taken China as an example, their primary sector service sector and secondary sector is industries and tertiary sector is agriculture. It means here the income, the economy gets income from these three sectors. Okay, so every economy designed on these three sectors, but the every country different from contributing share from different sectors. Our share is more in agriculture sector, USA share in more in industry sector, and China share in national income is from service sector. It means the share contributed from different sector is different from different countries. Are you understood? Next, importance of agriculture. Is there any advantages to do performing agriculture activities? We have to know. And share of agriculture. How much share comes to agriculture sector to national income? We have to know. Next, share of employment. How much employment provide from agriculture? We have to know in this topic. And providing raw material. Agriculture provides raw materials to service sector and industry sector. So, what type of raw materials it provided? We have to see here. And next, marketing for sector. So, what is mean by marketing? We have to know. Next, major crops in India. What type of crops are suited to Indian lands? We have to see here. And causes for the low productivity. What are the reasons to decline the share of agriculture? We have to discuss here. And major revolutions. What are the revolutions in agriculture? We have to do. How many loopholes are exist in agriculture? Also, we are discussing. And last one, conclusion. Are you clear, friends? Importance of agriculture. What importance of agriculture? Is there any importance of agriculture? So generally I am asking one question. Where we are performing agriculture sector? In metropolitan cities, mega cities? No, we are not performing any agriculture in mega cities, metropolitan cities. We are seeing agriculture activities in rural area. So agriculture played a significant role in rural livelihood. So I'm going to stress on three topics here, that is product contribution. What is mean by product contribution? Means the agriculture provides the food grains to the people and raw materials to industry sector. It means the agriculture contributed products to the people is called agriculture contribution. Food grains or products are not, it contributed or not? It contributed. That's why we call it as a product. We call it as a product contribution. And second one is factor contribution. Factor contribution is very, very important. So if any producer can produce the products they needs, they cannot produce any product with the use of these four factors of production. That every producer can produce the products with the using of these four factors like land, labor, capital, organization. So the producer can use the land and he paid for rent, and he can use the labor services, he paid wages to their services, and he can use the capital. We cannot start any production, any productivity without capital. Then they can use the capital. For the usage of capital, they can paid interest to capital, and finally organizing of these things, he get profits. Are you clear? He gets profit. And market contribution. What is market? Market is a place for buying and selling where producers and sellers are meet. One place is market. So agriculture purchasing some products from other sector, it also sells some products to other sector. It means demand and supply interdependency. Interdependency is called market contribution. One more thing here, factor contribution. In factor contribution, the agriculture sectors provides factors to industry sector. It means we have 1 acre of the land. We have to cut 1 acre crop. So we have to cut 1 acre of crop. So we need 10 laborers to cut the 1 acre of land in one day. So when we have developed agriculture sector, we are importing machines like crop cutter. It can cut the crop, 10 acre of the crop in one day. It means it displaces the 9 members. One machine, one man can cut the crop 10 acres in one day. So when you are using this, remaining 9 laborers can transport it to, displace it to other sector. Okay, are you clear? Share of agriculture. How much share comes from agriculture sector we are seeing. And during First World War time, the agriculture contribute 2/3 of the share to national income in the form of GDP. Okay, here when we are taking 100 as a round figure, 90% of the share comes from agriculture sector, only 10% of the share comes from other two sectors. Okay, what in 1950 to 51 it was 56%, 56.5%, minimum half of the share comes from agriculture sector, and in 2002 2001 it was 24.7%. In 2012 to 13, 13.9%. In 2013 to 14, 18.2. 15, 17.7. In 16, 17.9. And 17.2. And 18, 16.1. It means here the share is declined. So what is the reason to decline the share of agriculture? Means in First World War time, we are in Britishers and we are in Nizams. They are not providing education to people, and many of the people not known other sectors. They are not concentrated. They are not given important to other sectors. So we are all still as a traditionalist. We have everyone doing agriculture in during First World War time. Yeah, it means 1914 to 18. In 1951, the share of agriculture is declined because here in 1951, adapted. So that the reason the share of agriculture declined and importance of the secondary and tertiary sector is increased. Okay, this is the reason. And population pressure is heavy on the land. This is the second reason. You have to carefully observe here. So how much in 1951 we have, how much? 56 point here, 16.1%. It means what? It means the share of agriculture is declined. Already I told to you what are the reasons. Okay, share of employment. How much employment is created in agriculture sector, we have to see here. The number of people are engaged in agriculture sector. 98 millions people are engaged in agriculture in 1951. And in 2001, 230 millions are engaged. You have to see here the number of employment. We have to see here. The number of employment, 98 millions and 230 millions here. See once again, the employment share is, the employment increased on agriculture or decreased? The employment is increased from 98 millions to 235 millions. You have to go back to in before slide. In that slide, the share of agriculture is declined. So if the profits are less, they are using less laborers, right? So here the share of agriculture is increased. Next, the share of agriculture is decreased, but employment of agriculture increased. What the reason? Share is decreased, employment is increased. What is the reason to decrease and an increase of decreasing the employment in increasing the employment, increasing the share of agriculture is declined and employment in agriculture is inclined. What is the reason to employment increased? What is the reason to share is decreased? Means population pressure is heavy on the land. So population increased like a multiplication level and employment increased share from agriculture increased in a additions level. The share of the agriculture increased, productivity of the agriculture is increased in addition level, and employment population increased as a multiplication level, like 1 plus 1, this is in addition, 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1, 2 plus 2, it is in share productivity of agriculture, 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 4, 16, 16 into 16, 32, it increasing, population increased like this, and share productivity increased in plus 1, 2, 3, like that. So this is the reason. So share of the agriculture also increased, but the population double than the share is increased. Okay, are you clear? Agriculture sector provides raw material to other two sectors, service sector and industry sector. So food processing industries are directly depend on agriculture. Example, sugar, jute, cotton, vanaspati and plantation. So here I am giving one example for your clear understanding. So a farmer grows sugar cane. What? A farmer grows sugar cane. The sugar factory come to farmer and it transported into sugar factories. Then that modified into as a sugar. It modified into as final good. So here agriculture providing raw material or not? Agriculture sugar cane provided as a raw material and it again reback to the people through what? Sugar. Through the sugar. Are you understood? This is small scale industries, cottage industries are also depend on this agriculture sector. Friends, we have to know what types of crops are are growing in Indian lands. Okay, rice, wheat, maize, jowar, bajra, millet. These are the major crops in India. These are mostly suitable to Indian lands. Okay, Indian lands, mostly suitable to Indian lands. So, India is the second largest processor, largest producer of rice, wheat. Okay, are you understand? Friends, already I told to you, so every year the share of the agriculture is declined. So what is the reason to decline the share of agriculture? We have to know. So some of the causes, social causes, nothing but majority of the rural people are illiterate, superstitious and orthodox. They are not known how to use the modern techniques. They are always depend on traditional farmings. Okay, still now the some of the people are using traditional farm. This is the reason. And population pressure is heavy on the land, so more than people are engaged, the population is doubled, population is explosion. So over dependency has held in agriculture sector. So if the population increased, the land is decreased. So we have two laborers needed to work in agriculture field. But in family we have 4 members. Other 2 men does not have any employment. They are also engaged in agriculture sector. So what happened? Automatically the share was distributed among 4 members. It means already you know one famous Telugu quotation, that is magic mande kuvaithe magika palsana, like that. So in India, land degradation. So in India, land half of the land is degraded. It is not useful to cultivation, and some of the lands are not fertile. So it not have fertile land. That's why it not gives over production. Exercise of holdings are very low. So I have 1.5 acre of the land. How can I import the machines if it is suitable to small holdings? So I have 1.5 acre of land. When I was importing machines like crop cutter, it has 10,000. This is match for my size of holding. My 1.5 acre, it's not matching. That's why size of holdings of the lands are very low. This is the one of the reason. And inadequate infrastructure facilities are very low. So they are not due to that reason, they are not using modern techniques. They are not transported. They are not using fertilizers, good fertilizers from cities. And some other causes, like in India, tenant system are existing, zamindari system, you know, zamindari system. Zamin means land. In that time, tenant system is also one of the reason for causes of low productivity in India. So defects in agriculture. So what are the defects in agriculture? We have to know there are the several loopholes are exist in agriculture marketing. Lack of storage facility. Due to the lack of storage facilities, the farmer, due to the lack of storage facilities, the farmer can brought their paddy to markets. Very less storage facilities we have, so that the farmer keep their crop in the markets. Due to the unconditional unweather conditions, suddenly the rain was false. Due to this reason, the crop was spoiled. So if we have strong storage systems, widening the, we have more adequate storage facilities, then they cannot spoil their crop. And wrong machines. Agriculture market also, we have to see malpractices like wrong weights, machines, and they are not giving proper grading to the products like paddy. Lack of on-time marketing system. So on-time marketing here, so when the farmer goes to the market, then they are not they are not immediately marketing their paddy. So it takes some of the reason, it takes some time. So we have already seen number of times in social media the crop was spoiled, the crop was go to somewhere, the crop was merged into water. All these are reasons for the these are the defects for agriculture products. Finally, my conclusion is, our life is questionable without agriculture. It provides large amount of employment to the Indian people, but the farmer faced still many problems. So here the farmer suicides are happens, and we have famous quotations in India. Farmer is the backbone of nation. If the we doesn't have backbone, we live like a dead body. Without a farmer, we are all dead bodies. But he was a food producer to the world, but he doesn't have food, and he suffers from rural indebtedness, lack of credit facilities. And in my words, the government has taken more and more initiation to develop the agriculture sector and to increase the economic position of the farmers. And we have to provide some compensations to the who are losing their crop in unweather conditions and natural calamities. We have to providing minimum financial assistance to the farmers. I will thank to everyone who are giving this opportunity. So sorry friends, we have to discuss major revolutions in India. So major revolution means, what is meaning of revolution? Revolution, what is the aim of revolution? To change something exist in old times, right? So some of the major revolutions, we have to discuss what are the major revolution to change our agriculture system. Here green revolution. So green revolution, also known as new agriculture strategy of India, and in this green revolution we have to introduce a high yielding variety of seeds. It was the first time introduced in India. Swaminathan, he was the father of green revolution. Here HYV seeds are resulted. HYV due to the advent of HYV seeds, wheat production, cereals production, paddy production increased per hectare. And white revolution nothing but we have to increase in milk and dairy product. And silver revolution, agriculture not only the paddy, not only the wheat, not only the cereals, not only the pulses. We have to concentrate on these things also. So the white revolution, milk and dairy products, silver revolution, egg and poultry, and blue revolution, fishery, pink revolution, meat processing, golden revolution, honey, golden fiber, jute, and silver fiber revolution is cotton. We have high cost in jute bags, jute products, because the production of jute is very low in our country. We have to increase, that why it is called as a golden fiber revolution. One second, thank you for everyone. Thank you.